Hello, beautiful ones. Luann here. How are you? I'm going to do the reveal for our purpose message today. Just checking we are all good. All this technical stuff. I hope your Monday has gotten off to a beautiful start. And I've already actually pulled these cards for our message. So if you are new to the community here, I'm just even wondering if I've got this going on. So, yes, beautiful. Beautiful. Hey, Tamlin, hey, Bernadette, good to see you. In my office, I will tell you that I've got a window here, and sometimes I will put my desk there, but in feng shui terms, and you can ask Deb Moore, who's probably going to watch this later. She did this amazing reading for me, and so I sometimes switch my desk to go this way, right, because my door is over there. Why am I talking about this? Just waiting for people to come on. Yeah, sometimes I feel like I'm here, sometimes here. So anyway, okay, I forgot why I'm actually telling you that. But yes, feng shui. So this is why when you are in the right position, energetically, things flow better for you. So when I'm writing courses and doing certain things, I'll put my desk this way. And sometimes I just want to see out the window without cricking my neck. So anyway, this today, I think I'm talking about energy and all that kind of thing. Good to see you, Bernadette. Is because I am using the Abundance Oracle again by Sarupa. And we haven't got a date where I'm going to ask her to come in and do some readings and explain her awesome cards and how they were created, which is really, really awesome. Because I think everybody creates their own oracle deck, or who has done that. There's a different intention, I think. And I love reading, you know, where the background comes from, as I did my own. You know, that's won't go into that story. So if you are here and watching this, you can choose one, two, or three, or you can have the whole three. And this is a message to do with your purpose, how to express your purpose. If you're running a business surrounded by, you know, how you're expressing that through your business, your purpose through your business, or just in life in general, you know, that's all very good. So if you're watching the replay, do hashtag replay. And here we go. So the first card here, if you chose number one. Now, these are different cards in that she doesn't write a big message for them. So it's really up to your intuition or my intuition to see what they're about. And this one says, it's an affirmation. Right, I choose financial abundance. I choose financial abundance. So even just saying that, all of you, whether you're watching this, like, just close your eyes and I'm choosing financial abundance. Very interesting that it's at the time now of, you know, we've only got a couple of days here in Australia. We're coming to the year end. So accountants and bookkeepers are going to be very, very busy, probably are now, and leading up after the 1st of July. But to me, it's getting your affairs in order and choosing when your affairs are in order. And I like getting the taxes done, fixing up those little things, those little niggly things that you seem to push away, and you'll say, I'll get to that another time. For instance, we've got a TV here and it will not switch off, right? It will switch channels, it will do things like that. And it's been like that for a couple of weeks now, and I just leave it there. I turn it off at the wall, but it really needs repairing. So in that respect, if to get that fixed, then it's like, I don't know, Deb, maybe I need to interview you about feng shui. I know you do much more than that, but it seems to be the energetic things, right? Yes, Bernadette, did you pick this? It's like, complete them, get them fixed, throw out stuff that you don't no longer need, and let that financial, let that abundance come in for you. That's kind of what it feels for them, for this card. And it's got the beautiful ocean there and the triangle pointing downwards. So choosing, and maybe you just need to go and keep saying, I choose financial abundance. I choose financial abundance. Yeah, I like that. So if you have chosen number two, the second card here, this is called, well, interesting, number card number 30, and it's called conscious abundance. Conscious abundance. And it says, it's a more of a more of a command. And it says, if you chose number two, today give away at least five items you no longer use. Five items. Give them away to a charity. Now, hey Catherine, nice to see you. I love giving things away. I love making space, and these are abundance cards, remember? So similar to what we were saying in the first card, making space. We don't need, well, I don't need. You may need things, and I'm not a person who's like, yeah, go. If you love something, you want something, you go and get it. And it's not being about materialistic, it's honoring ourselves, right? Honoring ourselves. You can have whatever you want, should it be for the greatest good of yourself. So with this card, it's like clear out the clutter, make way for new things, and, you know, giving that reciprocation of the act of a gift to another person. My daughter is actually, with school holidays here, my daughter is 14. She's been putting some things on eBay. And so that's a good way. She doesn't have a job, and sometimes I'm just giving her some of my own things, and she sells them, and she's making some money too. So that's way of, you know, gifting things, and she's forever cleaning her room though. Yes, just so it's okay. So conscious abundance, giving five things away, and tell us, you know, if this is your card, show us, put a picture in. What did you give away? Or is there something you could gift away in the group here at all? You know, somebody, another person's trash is another person's treasure, right? Okay. So here is the third and final card. If you did the third card, oh, this is really interesting. Hey Tabitha, good to see you. This, I think we had this last week. Yeah, we did. So I love it when cards show up again, but it's in a different order. So if you chose one, two, or three, I think this was the second card. It's the third card now, and it says, well, I can't read that backwards. Your expansion is real. Hold your nerve. Your expansion is real. Hold your nerve. And I just feel like whoever's chosen number three, and I feel like I've chosen number three myself, is that there is something that you are working on, that you are expanding, especially to do with your purpose and a way of expressing it. And you may be just kind of like, oh, you may have a date in mind. Okay, this is just coming through. You've got a date in mind that you want to launch this thing or do this thing or ask this person. And it's like, yes, it's very real. Stay there. I mean, I don't mean stay there as in don't launch it. It's like holding that energy for that time, right? It's courage. It's courage. Hold that. Hold your nerve. It's coming soon. And when you're ready to launch, just launch. You know, it can be that easy. Just launch. Holding your nerve. I love this card. Very interesting. I think this whole, to me, I think this whole group is expanding. There's a different energy about it. Or I think there's something that I want to do within the group, but it might have to happen outside of the group. To me, that's my card. So if you, there's something that you need you to hold your nerve with, you're more than welcome to share with the group. You know, I think as we put things into the collective fire, it helps, it supports each other. So that is the reading today. I'm not too sure how long that went for, but if you are watching and you would like an extra card, just let me know. I always come on and there's not many people on here, so you might have already got your card in this lot, but if you do, I'll hang for just a few more minutes. And if you don't, that's totally fine too. That is totally fine. If you want another, your own card specifically for you, let me know. And you can actually share or like or comment on this. I actually do put these up on Instagram and YouTube and then share it with the tribe as well. I do cut off this end, but because this is really for you. Yeah, I don't send everybody's readings out. But if you would like one, just let me know. I'm just going to see. And if not, I'm going to pop off because I have got some things to do in another group. Yeah. I think that's made sense for you all. Okay, my gorgeous ones, I'm going to go out of here. No extra cards today. Love it, love it. I don't feel rejected at all. It's totally fine. Yes, your purpose, and bye for now. Have a great week.